On the first frames, we see laboratory rats released by scientists into a maze. Moving through it, a rat creates an internal map of its world and each time navigates the maze faster. This method of learning and memorization can also be applied to other species, including humans. A guy named Brendan is a video game developer and utilizes the principle described above in programming. One day Brendan had a picnic on the beach with his wife Claire and their daughter Sam. While the parents were sunbathing, Sam went to the shore to search for seashells, promising not to go into the water. Parenthood gave Brendan and Claire a purpose in life. Each day brought new memories, and each of them was important in its own way. When Sam's favorite doll accidentally fell into the water, she disobeyed her parents and went to pick it up. That day divided Brendan and his wife's life into before and after. They couldn't bear the loss of their daughter. Returning to her empty room was unbearable for them. Friends and relatives gathered at the wake to support the couple, but it didn't make it any easier for them. Brendan took the wife's hand. She said it is just unreal. Claire still refuses to believe that it happened for real. Later, she decided to remove Sam's belongings from her room, but the husband said he wasn't ready for that yet. Brendan wants the memories of Sam to continue living in their home. Suddenly he saw Sam's favorite book, The Berenstain Bears. For Brendan, it's now the most precious thing he has. At night, he couldn't sleep. Suddenly some sounds were heard from the kitchen, as if someone was rummaging in the fridge. Frightened, Brendan went to check what was happening. It turned out to be just Matt, his wife's brother. He came without permission because his sister and her husband allow him to do so. The guys had some drinks and talked heart to heart. At some point, Brendan mentioned that he noticed something strange. Like Matt, he remembered the title of the children's book as Berenstain instead of the Berenstain Bears. To confirm his guess, Brendan searched for information on the internet. It turned out that he wasn't the only one who had noticed this strange discrepancy with reality. Brendan found many articles about parallel universes and the Mandela effect, which refers to multiple people having false memories that coincide. Brendan didn't sleep all night. Claire told about his intention to go back to work. She wants to distract herself from grief in any way she can. Suddenly Brendan saw a family photo on the fridge and noticed another inconsistency. The wife claims it was taken at an observatory, but according to Brendan's memories, it was taken at a Pacific Science Center in Seattle. Brendan brought breakfast to Matt and then focused on the photograph. He vividly remembers it was taken in Seattle when they visited Claire's parents. Brendan shared his horrifying suspicions with Matt. He's almost certain that the Mandela effect is real. Many people around the world remember things that never happened. Of course, Matt didn't take the theory of parallel universes seriously, considering the Mandela effect to be nothing more than memory games. But Brendan is convinced that they all live in a simulation that occasionally malfunctions. The entire evening, Brendan spends in Sam's room. His wife, having already talked to her brother, is very worried about the husband and asks him not to dwell on it. However, Brendan continued his research on the internet. According to quantum mechanics theory, the world exists only when there is an observer looking at it. If the universe is indeed a matrix, then nothing can be impossible for a human. Soon Brendan visited a priest and asked why God took Sam. The priest replied that such a tragedy was not God's plan. Perhaps humans are never meant to know the meaning of Genesis. Brendan shared his thoughts again with Matt, who still remains skeptical about the Mandela effect. Matt believes that Brendan cannot accept reality and is searching for any other explanations. During dinner, Claire remained silent for a long time. She is concerned that her husband has become fixated on that internet theory. Brendan admitted that lately he has been noticing strange things. To convince his wife, he asked her about the character depicted on the Monopoly box. She was sure the character had a monocle, but in reality it was never there. And this is not the only discrepancy. Claire agreed that it was strange, but it doesn't prove anything. She thinks that her husband is going mad with grief. But Brendan hasn't changed his mind. He is convinced that Sam's demise is a glitch in the Matrix and that it can be fixed. One day the couple spent time at a bar with friends. Matt genuinely worries about Brendan, who pretended that everything was fine. Brendan actually delved into studying the Mandela effect. According to the theory, people do not live in a material reality but in a simulation. The question is only who simulated it. One of the proponents of this theory is Dr. Roland Fuchs, a renowned scientist who is trying to mathematically prove the truth of the Mandela effect. Brendan watched the physicist's lecture. He talked about how the universe was just a binary code. However, the file was corrupted, so Brendan couldn't finish watching the video. After recording a video message to the scientist and not receiving a response, Brendan went to the campus and sought out Dr. Fuchs. He told the scientist that he is here to find answers regarding the nature of the universe, but Dr. Fuchs refused to discuss it. Brendan feels like he's slowly losing his mind. One day he heard Sam's voice, but the illusion quickly passed. Claire wants her husband to seek help from a psychotherapist. Brendan promised to do so, but instead he went to Dr. Fuchs's home. Of course, the scientist was outraged by such an intrusive intrusion, but eventually agreed to listen to Brendan. The guy told Dr. Fuchs that after Sam's demise, he started noticing changes in the surrounding reality. Dr. Fuchs does not consider it paradoxical and believes that Brendan's obsession is related to grief and stress. Certainly, Brendan was disappointed with such an answer and continued to insist that he was right. The guy is determined to find and reprogram the universal code to bring back Sam. The programmer and the scientist went for a walk. According to Dr. Fuchs, if the theory is correct, something controlling the universe has tremendous power, but even in this system, glitches occasionally occur. The system does not spend power on simulating what's inside a building until someone wishes to enter it. Brendan understood that without an observer, there is no physical world. In computer game design, everything works on the same principle. This reinforced Brendan's determination to hack the universal code. But he found it difficult to imagine such a powerful computer that could influence reality. Then Dr. Fuchs told him about a university project to create a quantum computer. The scientist agreed to take Brendan to the laboratory and showed him a machine that was millions of times more powerful than any modern supercomputer. Dr. Fuchs explained how it works, but their conversation was interrupted by Manning, Fuchs' colleague, who asked the outsider to leave the lab. However, Brendan is resolute to return to the laboratory and reprogram reality to bring back his daughter. Dr. Fuchs is not sure if it will work. Shutting down the world even for a second is very dangerous. Manning's sudden appearance may be an attempt by the simulation to prevent the recoding process. That night, Brendan dreamed again of the fateful day that had ended his life. Suddenly he heard Sam's voice and woke up. When he went to the next room, he saw his daughter, who instantly disappeared like a system glitch. Claire understood that Brendan's mental state is worsening, but he doesn't consider himself crazy. Now he has no doubts that the world around him is a simulation. No elementary particle exists or possesses any properties until an observer fixes it. Right now, Brendan is heading to the quantum computer to finish what he started. He spent the entire night in the car, contemplating this. He is now balancing on the edge of reality and insanity. The next time Brendan woke up in his bed, he couldn't figure out what was real from the previous night and what was not. Brendan was in deep shock when he saw Sam. Claire behaved as if nothing had happened. Brendan is trying to make sense of the situation. Suddenly Claire asked where he was last night. Brendan barely held back his hysteria, saying that he had just seen Sam. The wife tried to calm him down. The first thing Brendan did was leave a voice message for Dr. Fuchs, saying that something was wrong. After that, Brendan started writing a program that would create a generation based on primitive game codes. Claire doesn't understand and doesn't know how to help her husband. This night, Sam came into their room, saying she had a nightmare. The next morning, the simulation disappeared. However, when Brendan went to the kitchen, he saw his daughter sitting at the table. Claire behaved again as if there had never been any tragedy. She genuinely doesn't understand why her husband is so scared. Suddenly Matt came in, who didn't notice anything out of the ordinary either. Brendan is on the verge of a nervous breakdown and still tries to reach Dr. Fuchs, but in vain. Sam had indeed returned to them. Life seems to have returned to normal, and their family became happy again, just like before. One night, Claire woke up from a nightmare and jumped out of bed. The husband tried to calm her down. Sam also woke up due to the commotion. The next morning, Claire said it was just a temporary blur, but now everything is fine. Brendan took the daughter to school. It seems that no one remembers the tragedy, so the recoding worked. When Brendan returned home, he immediately had a bad feeling. His wife had forgotten to turn off the stove and was standing by the window with tears in her eyes. She doesn't remember what happened in the last few minutes. Brendan took the family to a themed cafe to distract Claire. However, she looked detached, as if something had broken within her. At some point, Brendan noticed that the cup in his hand had begun to crack on its own. Claire suddenly snatched the cup from his hand and smashed it on the floor. She had a nervous breakdown. At home, Claire went straight to bed. Matt, very concerned about his sister's condition, came to help. Sam asked her father if everything will be okay with Mom. Brendan promised his daughter that the mother will get better soon. Suddenly Claire entered the room and started screaming that Sam shouldn't be here. The situation is getting out of control. Later, Brendan asked Matt to look after Sam and Claire, while he went to Dr. Fuchs' house, but some woman opened the door instead. Brendan was shocked to learn from her that Roland had passed away. According to the woman, it happened suddenly. He became a paranoid and voluntarily left this life 2 months ago. Brendan can't understand how it's possible, as he had just talked to the scientist recently. A glass in Brendan's hand started to crack on its own again. Brendan hurried back home to write a new code for a new simulation. If he's right, it will work. Before proceeding with his plan, Brendan recorded a video message. He is not crazy, he is just seeking the truth. Leaving a note on the computer monitor, Brendan spent the next morning with his daughter. While Sam played the piano, Brendan recalled all the happy moments of their life. Later, Brendan returned to the laboratory to upload the new code into the quantum computer. However, Manning tried to interfere again. Brendan had to attack the scientist to neutralize him and take his pass. After that, Brendan acted quickly. He uploaded the code, and reality began to change. Brendan left the laboratory and found himself in the empty campus. While he was on the bus, Claire called him, saying she was scared. According to Claire, strange things were happening around her. Brendan realized it too, seeing a woman fall through the floor of the bus like a computer glitch. But that was just the beginning of something much more horrifying. Brendan ran out of the bus, the reality around him constantly changing. Apparently, a fatal error had been made in his code, triggering an irreversible process. When Brendan returned home, he noticed glitches in the textures of reality. Brendan hugged his family, watching objects flicker and disappear around them. Suddenly, even Claire herself started to disintegrate into textures. At some point, everything went dark. Brendan realized too late that the quantum computer was not to be trifled with. However, the universal algorithm knows how to repair itself. In the final frames, we see Brendan, his wife and daughter having a picnic at the beach. At one point, Sam went looking for seashells again. The parents allowed her, but Brendan asked his daughter to leave her doll here. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel not to miss more exciting new products. Also, the authors will be pleased if you leave your opinion in the comments.